Nityanandam. Hi there. How are you all? Are you ready for story listening session? Now I'd like to introduce two characters to you. Here is Moshu, the caterpillar, and this is Shuka, who will talk to you. He is the parrot. And what is the story you would like to listen most? Shall I tell you something from India? Some special story from India? Yes. Have you heard of Mahabharata? Have you heard of Bhagavatam? These are all old, old books. Many, many thousands of years the stories are going on. Mahabharata is the longest poem. Do you know that? It is so long, there are 100,000 verses in that. Such a long story. I'm going to tell you that story. I hope you all enjoy it. And you all come to know what is there India has to offer. All of you will be very familiar with Indian lives. Right? Yay. Come on. Let's start with the story. Yes. Now Shuka is very ready. He's listening very cleanly. And Moshu is almost asleep. I have to wake him up. Yeah, I'll wake him up. Come on, Moshu, listen. Now, Mahabharata. Do you know who is the person who wrote the story? Some of your parents might have told you, or you might have read in some book. Yes, it is a great sage by name Vedavyasa. Please listen once more. It's a great sage by name Vedavyasa. He wrote Mahabharata. And he was an eyewitness to the whole story. He was there living along with the princes who are the heroes of the story. The story is about Pandavas, the five brothers, and Kauravas, their cousins, who are 100 brothers. They had a lot of problem amongst themselves. Yes, 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 please continue with the story. I want to listen. Shuka is very keen. He wants to listen to the story. Come on. Now, this Vedavyasa, he has seen the whole story. He has seen the life of the princess whom he has helped, and the cousins who were also there, and he knew about everyone. So he wanted to tell the whole story to the whole world. That is why he wanted to write Mahabharata. And for writing that, he is a poet who can think of the poem, but he can't immediately write it also. So he needed somebody to work as a writer, one who will be a scribe and write what he says. So he was wondering whom to ask. Somebody who has to be very intelligent. You can't just like that blindly write down everything. No, you'll have to be intelligent. Only then you'll write it correctly. So he wanted somebody. He prayed. And then he thought of Ganesha. Do you know who Ganesha is? Yes. Yes, some of you are telling me. All of you have seen the statue, right? Of an elephant-headed god. He is the son of Lord Shiva. Ganesha is very intelligent. He is known for intelligence. We pray to him so that we get intelligence, right? And so Vedavyasa thought of Ganesha and said, I'll ask him, I'll pray to him. And since Vedavyasa is a great saint, as soon as he thought of Ganesha, immediately Ganesha appeared before him and asked him, what is it you want of me? Vedavyasa said, please, I have a big story ready and I want to tell the children all over the world the story. And I need somebody to write the whole story. Will you help me write it? Ganesha was very pleased. He likes stories just like you all. He likes like Moshu and Shuka also. So he was also very keen to know the story. But since he was asked, he was a little proud. He said, no, I'll write only when you fulfill my condition, he said. Vedavyasa said, what is the condition you want me to fulfill? Ganesha said, see, you know I write well. You know I'm a scribe who is very fast in writing. So, you have to tell a story which is without break, you have to tell me. Then only I can write. If you make me stop in between, I will get away and go away. He was a little proud. But Vedavyasa knew Ganesha is very strong in writing. And Vedavyasa, he was also intelligent. He said, shall I put one condition? Ganesha was ready for any challenge. He said, okay, I'll fulfill that condition. Vedavyasa said, whatever I tell you, whatever verse, he'll tell in poem form. Verse means poem. So in poem form, I'll tell the story. When you're writing, you should understand every word I'm telling and then write. Do we do that? When we learn something, do we understand and write everything? No. But see how they have lived there. They have always, the teacher will teach something, the student will understand and then write. Till then they won't write. So here, Ganesha had put the condition, Vedavyasa has accepted it. Vedavyasa put a return condition, Ganesha was ready. Both had started. Ganesha was ready with this writing pen. In olden days they had stick. And they used to write on palm leaf. They didn't have paper then. So on palm leaf, he'll write with a stick. And those palm leaves, even now you find in many places, many libraries have palm leaves. If you get a chance, please go and visit libraries and see these stories written originally. There, Vedavyasa started narrating. And Vedavyasa was very intelligent. He knew he cannot stop Ganesha. So what will he do? He thought of some difficult verses. When I give a difficult verse, Ganesha has to think of the meaning and write. He'll take 1 minute extra. In that 1 minute, I'll get many verses ready in my mind. Likewise, he put every 12th verse a little difficult verse. So by the time Ganesha would write that first verse, 12 verses will be ready in Vedavyasa's mind. Likewise, they kept writing and writing for days together, months together. The story went on and on and on. Finally, suddenly, Ganesha's pen broke. Now he has told Vedavyasa, I cannot stop writing. So he has to keep up his word. What did he do? He immediately broke his tusk. That is the commitment he had. He did not want to stop anything. So he broke his tusk and started writing. That is why you see many of the Ganesha statue which have half the tusk broken. And you may have Ganesha's holding tusk in his hand. That means he was ready to write everything. So for years together, they wrote the story of Mahabharata. And till today, it is the longest poem. 100,000 verses are there in that Mahabharata. Now, let me tell you the first story, which is interesting. We will start with one of the ancestors, forefathers. You say grandfather, grandfather and grandfather of the heroes. Heroes are the Pandavas. The name of 5 brothers together. They are called Pandavas. And they have a 100 brother strong cousins called Kauravas. They form the main characters in this whole story. Now, one of their ancestors, his name was Shantanu. Please learn the names, because once you read them, you will understand, yeah, I heard the story when I was young. I heard with the characters Moshu and Shuka. Both of them are listening very keenly. Right? So, that Shantanu was a ruler of a place called Hastinapura. This place will be very important in Mahabharata, because that's the main center in which entire story takes place. And he was a very good, just king. He was ruling very well. One day, while he was walking along in a calm manner along the river Ganges. Have you heard of Ganges? Yes, you would have. In your geography book, you can see it. India, we have a long river called Ganges. It is a river that comes down from Himalayas right up to the sea. This Ganges, along the river, he was walking and taking a cool evening. He was walking along the Ganges River. Suddenly, he saw a beautiful lady. And the king was very young. He thought, yeah, this lady looks nice. I would like to get married to her. I would like to live with her. So, what did he do? He went and approached her. He said, I wish to marry you. Would you agree to my marriage? Immediately he asked. That lady, she was also interested. She said, I will marry you. But I have a condition. Like Ganesha and Vedavyasa, she also had a condition. She said, after I marry, whatever I do, you should not question me. Whatever I, you should not ask my background also. You should not ask anything about me. You've seen me now, you wanted to marry me, I'm willing to marry you. But don't ask anything about me. Or whatever I do, that also you should not question me at all. That was the condition she put. The king liked her so much, he didn't even think the condition was something strong. He didn't think anything about it. He said, okay, I'll marry you. I'll accept all the conditions. And he married her. Many years, they had a beautiful life. Happy together. You've read in fairy tales, no? Happily ever after. Like that they both lived. In those years, after some years, they got a child. First child was born. Immediately, Ganga, her name is Ganga. She is the river goddess who has come in a form. That Ganga took the newborn baby and went and put it into the river, drowned the child into the river. The king was shocked, but he remembered what she has told him. What did she say? She said, you should not question whatever I do. If you question, immediately I'll leave you, she has told him. The king was, he liked her so much. That's why he couldn't even question what she is doing. He just swallowed his sorrow and just left it at that. In the same manner, year after year, they had children, 7 children. And all the 7 children, as soon as they are born, she went and put them into the river. What a horrible thing the king has facing. But since he loved her so much, he did not question her because he was scared she'll leave and go off. Then, after the 8th child was born, immediately she took that child also and she was about to leave it in the river. The king could not hold himself. He's been holding his patience for so long. Now, impossible. He said, please, why are you throwing this child also? Let this child be alive. Please leave him. Immediately, Ganga told, I have told you the condition. Now you have gone back on your condition. You have questioned me. Why is it you are doing? You asked me the question. No, that is why you are questioning me what I am doing. Now I will explain to you what I am doing. And then, but I cannot stay anymore with you. Then she tells a story. The Mahabharata will have story within story within story within story. It will go on and on. Because that is how life is. Life. One day we may face something and somebody will come and tell you some incident related to that. So one person's story carries on to another person's story, carries on to the next person. Likewise, story within story within story. Now, shall we continue the next story now? Or shall I continue it later? Yay. Okay. Shuka and Moshu wants to say bye to you. Bye.